which we added $3.5 million in local taxpayers' money. I want to thank the government for that grant. We are joined this morning by Andrew Velasquez, Regional Administrator for the Federal Emergency Management Agency. I want to thank Council Brian Herman of the Canadian Consulate for joining us today. The boat was manufactured in Canada. I'll think of that. That is amazing. Government and with state and regional agencies is a big part of our strategy to use state-of-the-art technology to be able to manage emergencies. Today's dedication is especially meaningful because we are naming this boat after Chicago firefighter paramedic Christopher Wheatley, who, as we all know, lost his life last year fighting fire on the Near West Side. It's important that we keep alive the name and memory Chris Wheatley, and all members of the Gold Badge Society. When you think of that, all the men and women that have lost their lives. We need to remember Chris, the individual, because he was an extraordinary young man who left us much too soon. He shared this great spirit with our city, far beyond his firefighting duties, by working to keep our young people away from alcohol and drugs, by teaching emergency medical techniques at the University of Illinois in Chicago. We also need to remember Chris Wheatley, for we know broadly he represented all the members of the great Chicago Fire Department. I had a great opportunity growing up in Bridgeport. I told that yesterday, at Engine 29. And so I grew up as a young man with firemen and policemen all my life. And I always remember their greatness to all the young people of our community, even continuing today. The fire department has a great response. All the young men and women, the young kids will look up to you, and you have to realize that. Like all first responders, he willingly put his life on the line every day to uphold the law and protect the public safety of our residents. Chicago would not function if it weren't for Chris Wheatley, and thousands like him are willing to be in dangerous jobs every day so the rest of us can live in safety. Brave men such as Corey Ankrum and Edward Stringer also gave their lives last year in the service of the people of Chicago. It has been one of the great privileges of my service as mayor to be able to work closely with men and women who like Chris Wheatley and many others. Keeping our communities safe, our waterways safe, our securities secure today is not an easy job. But through the commitment of the men and women of the fire department, who are well-trained personnel, who look at technology and creativity, and understand they need support in regards to emergencies, they need direction and support and command. I congratulate Commissioner Robert Hoff. I congratulate all the members of the fire department, for I believe this is the best fire department. And not only now, being our global city, I don't just say America, but I say throughout the world. You are looked upon as the great innovators, use of technology in fighting emergencies here in the city of Chicago. God bless you and thank you.
Today is the day that Chicago Fire Department is waiting for, have been waiting for with great anticipation. The christening of our first fireboat to be delivered in Chicago since 1949. The purchase of Engine Company 2 would not have been made possible if it not had been for the grant funding from the Department of Homeland Security and the efforts of our partners at the Office of Emergency Management and Communications, Department of Fleet Management, the Department of General Services, and Hike Metal Productions of Ontario, Canada, the manufacturer of this beautiful vessel. Also, I'd like to acknowledge Assistant Deputy Fire Commissioner Michael Fox, who put a lot of time and effort into this design of this boat. Thank you all very much. To be on board the boat, along with the Wheatley family. We haven't purchased a boat in over 60 years. This boat is 90 feet long, weighs 300 tons, can go 14.8 knots or 16 miles per hour. It's going to cover 28 miles of lakefront for the Chicago Fire Department. It can pump over 14,000 gallons of water a minute. And it can also break up the 12 inches of ice, which is going to help us in the wintertime in the city of Chicago. It's going to have an officer, two engineers, and a firefighter, a pilot, on board. Folks, thank you all for coming today.
Red up.
Backside.
Oh yeah.
My dad worked a lot.
I got my phone.
Oh yeah.
You
and all of them wet
and save me.
And Chris is up there laughing.
Oh, they can remotely do that.
Oh yeah. Fantastic. They even have handheld remotes. You can walk around.
Oh man.
Stand. You can go up on the platform and use the handheld to the front, from the door, to the back. Yeah.
Kim, I got a bunch of them.
Oh, okay, good. Thanks.
Did you wet?
Yeah, that's not too bad. You probably won't
mind. I know you will. I'll just
hop in. You want me to do that?
Oh.
Holy Moses, look at that.
Wee bit of water. Yeah.